Hi Hunters, it's Olga from ANY.RUN. In our tutorial video series, we review all ANY.RUN's features that can be useful for your malware analysis. You can check them all on the link in the upper right corner. Today we'll take a look at the retrospective analysis and malicious documents clusterization. For example, a malicious documents or script doesn't download the payload. In these cases, analysts can determine what type of malware it was using a retrospective analysis and ANY.RUN's filter. Let's open the task from my history. As you can see, there isn't any malware detected. But if you look closely at HTTP requests, then you find that PowerShell process tried to connect to different URL addresses but didn't receive a payload. The URL addresses and file names like this tell us that it could be a Qbot, aka Quackbot Trojan. Now let's restart the task, add more time and see what happens. Unfortunately, it didn't get any better. Let's go another way. Then I stopped the task and going to find another working one, which payload was downloaded in public submission tab. It's very easy for using. I need just copy domain name, then open filter and paste it into domain field. There are numerous tasks we can see. Let's open the one where malware was detected and check it. Here we are. Now we go to the network section and check the HTTP request. The payload was downloaded. And as I suggested, this is Qbot Trojan, which was detected by a local signature. While doing retrospective analysis, malware analysts can use all information from tasks, such as hash sums, IP addresses and domain names, file names, meteoretic techniques IDs, circuit rule signature IDs, etc. Let's also talk about malicious documents clusterization conception. Here you can see malloc from this task marked as a malloc 49. Malloc clustered based on the different options such as malware family, downloads or drops, visual similarity, similarity of its content, and more. In our case, malloc was clustered based on the one of the following facts. First, at the time of creation, it downloads Qbot exclusively. Second, malloc contains similarity. And third, its malloc's decode visual similarity. Clusterization very convenient when we talk about retrospective analysis. Look, just clicking on the icon, you are forwarded to the public submissions with tasks filtered by malloc 49 tag. It allows you to take a look at other tasks with malloc 49 and collect IX from them. For example, different IPs and domain names used by malware family. Or you can see how did the infection process of particular malware goes before and many other things. Have you ever tried detection malware this way? Share your story with me. In the meantime, you can go to our service and look for a similar task there. The link as usual is below this video. I hope today's lesson was useful and you've learned something new. Don't hide your thumbs and comments. They inspired us to share with you more helpful information about ANY.RUN service. See you in the next videos. Bye!